Hi, Dee Dee. New to the program.
Hi, Dee Dee.
There's a lot of dudes in here. Sorry, my other program isn't such a sausage fest. My NA sponsor said I needed to come here because, tell the truth and tell it fast, the only way I know how to relate to men is sex. It's been that way forever. I can remember my mom screaming at me for grinding on my cousin when I was like 4 years old. I took my neighbor's virginity by force when I was 12. Seduced my high school English teacher, got him fired when he tried to break it off. My 20s, two abortions, one long game of musical fuck chairs. So, now I'm 30, single, no dude, no kids, and I just lost my best friend in the whole world because I fucked her old man. I didn't even like the douchebag, but that's what I do. There's gotta be another way. There has to be, or I'm gonna fucking kill myself. So, that's what I got. Thanks.
Keep coming back.
Keep coming back.
Found this gentleman loitering out in your hall.
Nick, I'm busted.
Says he knows he's in trouble.
Yeah.
We're all in trouble. You don't have to be afraid. You're safe here.
Okay.
What's your name, honey?
I am, I am Blanston.
Hi, Blanston.
Hi, Blanston.
Hi.
Well, it's nice to have some fresh blood in the group.
Appreciate it.
Fresh, cute blood.
Hey.
Easy, Julia. Blanston, would you like to share with us what's led you into recovery?
Well, okay. I do have a very big problem. Just been hitting it hard. I've been hitting it hard.
He thinks he's in an AA meeting.
Getting together with the guys, oftentimes ending up just face down. Chugging one after the other, sometimes double-fisted, just you know what I'm talking about.
So your sexual addiction, it's homosexual in nature.
My sex addiction. My sex addiction is, and then what did you say?
The beauty of your feelings, and say the words. Come on.
I love you, Dad. I love you too, son.
That's a
Okay, group, we have some newcomers here today with us. Say hello to Scott and his father, Mr. Avil?
Evil, actually. Dr. Evil.
Hello, Dr. Evil. Hello, Scott.
Hello, everybody.
So, Scott, why don't we start with you? What brings you here with us today?
Well, I just really met my dad for the first time 5 days ago.
I was partially frozen his whole life.
That is beautiful that you can admit to that.
He comes back and now he wants me to take over the family business.
But Scott, who's gonna take over the world when I die?
Listen to the words he used. Who's going to take over the world when I die? Feels like that to some of us sometimes, doesn't it? Yes. So, what do you want to do, Scott?
I don't know. I was thinking I like animals. Maybe I'd be a vet.
An evil vet?
No. Maybe like work in a petting zoo.
An evil petting zoo?
You always do that! I just think like he hates me. I really think he wants to kill me.
Now, Scott, we don't want to kill each other in here. We might say that we do sometimes, but we really don't.
Actually, the boy's quite astute. I really am trying to kill him, but so far unsuccessfully. He's quite wily, like his old man.
This is what I'm talking about.
Okay, well, we've heard from you, Scott. Now, you tell us a little about yourself.
The details of my life are quite inconsequential.
Oh, no, please, please. Let's hear about your childhood.
Yeah, okay. Come on, come on.
Very well. Where do I begin? My father was a relentlessly self-improving boulangerie owner from Belgium with low-grade narcolepsy and a penchant for buggery. My mother was a 15-year-old French prostitute named Chloe with webbed feet. My father would womanize, he would drink, he would make outrageous claims like he invented the question mark. Sometimes he would accuse chestnuts of being lazy, the sort of general malaise that only the genius possess and the insane lament. My childhood was typical. Summers in Rangoon, luge lessons. In the spring, we'd make meat helmets. When I was insolent, I was placed in a burlap bag and beaten with reeds. Pretty standard, really. At the age of 12, I received my first scribe. At the age of 14, a Zoroastrian named Vilma ritualistically shaved my testicles. There really is nothing like a shorn scrotum. It's breathtaking. I suggest you try it.
You know, we have to stop.
Now, I know coming here isn't easy for anyone, but this support group is here to help you. And recent events like Brexit have stirred up a lot of feelings. And you've all come to realize something shocking. You've realized that not everyone thinks exactly the same as you do. Susan, maybe you'd like to share your story.
Thanks, Kay. Well, the thing is, I used to look at my Facebook and think, it's fine. We all basically agree with each other. And then, last June, the Brexit result, I gradually began to realise that there are people in the world who don't think the same as me.
Joseph, you had something to say.
Yeah. I went into work the day after the referendum, and some people were happy. And I realised, if people don't agree with me about that, maybe they don't agree with me about other things. I mean, some things we all agree on, like the Star Wars prequels, everyone thinks they're shit.
Oh, I quite like them.
Well, I don't think they're as bad as everyone says.
This can't be happening. What's the matter with you? Why can't everyone be right, like me?
Is this the place for the different opinion support group?
Yes, that's right. Please, come in.
I'm Frank.
Welcome, Frank. Now, remember, you can say anything you want here. It's a very safe environment.
Oh, great, thanks. It's got so I'm afraid to open my mouth in public. But, you know, it's not all doom and gloom, is it? I mean, happy anniversary.
Did you find a partner?
And this is how I met the big Moosey. His eyes already shrink-wrapped in tears. Knees together. Those awkward little steps.
My name is Bob.
Bob.
Bob had been a champion bodybuilder. You know that chest expansion program you see on late night TV? That was his idea.
I was a juicer. You know, using steroids, diabinol, and Wisterol. Oh, they use that on racehorses, for Christ's sakes. And now I'm bankrupt. I'm divorced. My two grown kids won't even return my phone calls.
Strangers with this kind of honesty make me go a big rubbery one.
Go ahead, Cornelius. You can cry.
And then Something happened. I let go. Lost in oblivion. Dark and silent and complete. I found freedom. Losing all hope was freedom.
It's okay.
Babies don't sleep this well.
Did you hear that Dr. Yang and Dr. Hunt are getting married?
I did.
It's pretty great, huh? It's almost like a silver lining. You know, I've read a lot about trauma and how sometimes people just up and change their lives. They say that the trauma was the best thing that could have happened to them. You know, like Dr. Shepherd this morning. Did you hear that he's not chief anymore?
And how have you been, Dr. Gray? You've been through a lot since I last saw you. Does anyone have anything to say? I know that a lot of you are only here because this has been mandated. So, let's talk. Anything at all?
I ate a really good taco from one of those trucks by the side of the road.
When?
Last night, you were asleep.
In which truck? The one on 7th?
I want to go. I like tacos.
Me too. I read a book about the history of mass murders in the U.S. You know, that's the actual name of what happened to us. It was a mass murder. You can't call it a terrorist attack because the murders weren't political in nature, and we weren't the victims of a serial killer because Mr. Clark would have had to murder several people over a period longer than 30 days in order to qualify as a serial killer. Now, we could call it a spree killing, which is defined as killings at two or more locations with no break or pause in between because Mr. Clark shot that guy in his car before he got here. But I'm not sure that that counts as a true second location since it was so close to the hospital, which means that we were a mass murder. Because it happened at one place, by one person, and more than four people were killed.
These conflicts are normal. This is a highly unusual relationship, and that's what this support group is for. Jonathan would like to share again.
I mean, I'm only saying because this reminded me of something I was journaling just the other day. I feel really bad because Karen and I are fighting a lot because I think she's becoming morbidly obese.
And I keep reminding him that she is pregnant.
And then I realized that I am, manorexic. And it's really hard because she's so fat. And I love Christopher so much, and he's fat, and I'm afraid the baby's gonna be fat, and it's just me and two fatties.
I'm proud of you, Jonathan. Thank you for sharing that.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Thank you. Anyone else?
I can go.
Dave.
The wife and I are Methodists. Ashley here is a Wiccan. It's kind of like a witch. They have stores, I think. But, you know, at first I was a little worried about a witch carrying my child, but I came around to the idea. Or she put a spell on me. Did she do that, Ashley? I'm sorry.
I'd like to share something.
Please.
Okay, I don't know, like, all the therapy terms.
Well, I don't know the therapy terms either. I don't go to therapy.
Yeah, but I just like to say that Kate is always up in my business.
Well, when someone falls asleep with a curling iron in their hair, it becomes necessary to insert yourself in their business.
That happened 2 times.
Angie, bottom line, you're Karen Kate's baby. And you do want to get paid, right?
Yeah.
That means that Kate does deserve some input. But Kate, you must remember that a surrogate is not your employee, but your partner.
Yeah, Kate, we're partners. Like Tom and Jerry.
Tom and Jerry hate each other.
They love each other. What show are you watching?
They're a cat and a mouse.
They have okay, so much fun together.
Children in Japan can understand
that. Oh, you are dead wrong.
I want you two to spend more time together.
Oh,
that's impossible.
Yeah,
let Angie help you get ready for the baby. Decorate the nursery together. Pick out a crib. Do all the things you would do if you were pregnant. Just do them with Angie.
Thank you.
Chaz, would you like to start the day off by sharing?
I was just trying to find some peace. A haven, a place where I could feel safe.
And then what happened?
Well, she was my yoga instructor. So I knew she was limber.
But you, Chaz, you realize this would just set you back and further hurt your progress in maintaining control over your libido, correct?
Yes. Thank you, Taylor. Okay. Definitely. Until her friend, massage therapist, walked in the door, naked.
Easy, Chaz.
A big bottle of canola oil and a monkey who was trained to work on a video camera. And she rocked my world.
Okay. Guys, Chaz, I have asked you to leave before, and I don't want to do it again.
Taylor, come on, man.
Let's just move on. Who'd like to talk about chlamydia, syphilis, gonorrhea, etc.?
Hi. Sorry I'm late. I was, having sex. A lot.
Welcome. Welcome. Why don't you, go ahead and introduce yourself?
I know her.
I'm Katie.
And?
Oh, and I'm a sex addict.
Hi, Katie.
Hey, Katie.
Why don't you go ahead?
Wow, so you're a sex addict too.
Sex, what can I say?
Right, I mean, you said it all. It's such a burden. I mean, people don't realize what we go through on a day-to-day basis.
Why don't you come to my room tonight and we can comfort each other? 11:55, sharp.
Come on, people, break it up!
Why are we meeting in here? It's cramped.
Well, Everton, we're meeting in here so that Rudy can participate.
It's cramped.
Does anyone else have a thought on that?
Cramped!
I think he has a question.
You find that funny, Hunter, making fun of a man's infirmity?
Maybe he does have a question. He's alive.
He's catatonic.
He still has a brain. Maybe he wants to participate, too.
Yeah. Maybe he has a question.
Yeah. Maybe he knows why we're cramped.
Maybe Beanie knows a lot more than we give him credit for. Excuse me, Beanie?
Which way is heaven?
That's correct. That'll be enough, Hunter.
Beanie, how much taller is Will Chamberlain than you?
Right.
Hey, Beanie! Where's the ceiling?
That's enough. Stop it.
Where do the birds fly, Beanie?
How do you say hello to Hitler?
Beanie, how does Hitler say hello?
Hey, Beanie, how do you check an elephant for a hernia? Beanie, who'd win a staring contest? Beanie!
Who fought it?
Beanie! Who likes to masturbate? Yeah! Hey, Beanie! How's the way on referee? Say field goal!
Hey, Beanie!
Ciao, Beanie! Arigato, Beanie!
Bye, Beanie. It was really a good session, I thought.
Why are we meeting in here? It's cramped.
Well, Everton, we're meeting in here so that Rudy can participate.
It's cramped.
Does anyone else have a thought on that?
Cramped!
I think he has a question.
You find that funny, Hunter, making fun of a man's infirmity?
Maybe he does have a question. He's alive.
He's catatonic.
He still has a brain. Maybe he wants to participate, too.
Yeah. Maybe he has a question.
Yeah, maybe. Maybe he knows why we're cramped.
Maybe Beanie knows a lot more than we give him credit for. Excuse me, Beanie?
Which way is heaven?
Correct.
That'll be enough, Hunter.
Beanie, how much taller is Will Chamberlain than you?
Right.
Hey, Beanie! Beanie! Where's the ceiling?
That's enough. Stop it.
Where do the birds fly, Beanie?
How do you say hello to Hitler?
Beanie, how does Hitler say hello?
Hey, Beanie, how do you check an elephant for a hernia? Beanie, who would win a staring contest? Beanie!
Who fought it?
Beanie!
Who likes to masturbate?
Yeah!
Hey, Beanie, how's the one-arm referee say field goal?
Hey, Beanie!
Ciao, Beanie! Arigato, Beanie!
Bye, Beanie. It was really a good session, I thought.
Harding, you've stated on more than one occasion that you suspected your wife of seeing other men.
Oh, yes. Yes, very much. I suspect her. I suspect her.
Well, maybe you can tell us why you suspect her.
Well, I can only speculate as to the reasons why.
Have you ever speculated, Mr. Harding, that perhaps you are impatient with your wife because she doesn't meet your mental requirements?
Perhaps, but you see, the only thing I can really speculate on, Nurse Ratched, is the very existence of my life with or without my wife in terms of the human relationships, the juxtaposition of one person to another, the form. The content.
Hardy, why don't you knock off the bullshit and get to the point?
This is the point. This is the point, Tabor. It's not bullshit. I'm not just talking about my wife. I'm talking about my life. I can't seem to get that through to you. I'm not just talking about one person. I'm talking about everybody. I'm talking about form. I'm talking about content. I'm talking about interrelationships. I'm talking about God, the devil, hell, heaven. Do you understand? Finally!
Yeah, Hardy, you're so fucking dumb, I can't believe it.
Oh. It makes me feel very peculiar when you throw in
peculiar.
Something like that.
Why?
What does that
peculiar?
Mean?
Peculiar, Harding.
Peculiar.
Peculiar, Harding.
Peculiar.
I want to tell you guys something. You just don't want to learn anything. You just don't want to listen to anybody.
Wait a minute.
He's peculiar. Got intelligence.
Wait a minute. You've never heard the word peculiar? Say, what are you trying to say? Trying to say I'm queer? Is that it?
No,
little Marianne? Little Marjorie Jen? On the street? Huh? Is that it? Is that what you're trying to tell me? Is that your idea of communicating something to me? Is it? Well, is it?
Oh. They're all crowding in on you, Mr. Harding. They all ganging up on you.
Is that news?
No, they sometimes want to gang up on me, too, but
Cheswick, do me a favor.
Huh?
Take it easy.
Take it.
And stay off my side.
But I only wanna help you.
I understand.
But don't you want me to?
Please.
But I only wanna.
Please.
But I only wanna help you.
Please. You see, the other day, you made some allusions, both of you.
Ooh.
To sexual, yes, allusions. Allusions, not illusions, allusions. To sexual problems I might be having with my wife. All right, let's say it's true. Let's say I know it to be true, but you don't.
And if that's your idea of trying to tell me something, you got another thing coming.
Oh, Hardy, I mean, you're some kind of morbid asshole or something.
Yeah.
Oh, asshole.
Makes you feel peculiar.
Peculiar.
Been talking about your wife ever since I can remember. You know, she's on your mind and blah, 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 and on and on and on.
I'm not talking about my wife. When are you going to get that through your thick fucking head?
When are you going to wise up and turn it off?
I don't want to hear it.
Please, no, just peculiar.
I don't want to
hear it. I'm tired.
I don't want to hear it.
It's a lot of baloney. It's a lot of baloney, and I'm tired.
All right, Cassie, you'll be better in the morning. We know you're tired. We're all tired.
I'm tired, and it's a lot of baloney.
You're not tired, Mancini.
I don't like what's happening here.
Well, wait a minute. Let's try to use a feeling word.
I'm pissed.
Okay, pissed. Why?
Because no way should she be here.
All right, but tell her.
No way should you be here.
That's right. That's the rule. No using. You broke it.
I'm sorry.
Sorry, my ass. All you've done since you got here is sit around while the rest of us work our butts off.
I realize.
And now you expect us to be glad that they let you stay.
I'm not expecting anything. Gwen, just listening. Everybody. Feeling words.
I don't think you are giving. I don't feel that you are giving personally.
I'm
That's
trying.
Not what you mean. I don't think you have niceness. You see, I don't feel niceness coming from you.
Should I just go to another group?
Oh, that'd be a great idea. You could spread your negativity even further.
Daniel.
You know, if you really try,
Daniel.
You could ruin the experience for the entire
Daniel,
patient population.
I'm having a bad day. I'm having the worst damn day of my whole damn life. So if it is not too much to ask of you people, will you just back the fuck off?
Excellent work. Really excellent work. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Good sharing, everybody.